It's amazing how the positive response that we receive from hyperscalers, a lot of it really is just trying to get comfortable with the behind the meter power generation, to be frank, because no one's really done that.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Will Gray. He is the CEO of New Era Energy and Digital. And Will, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Hey, I'm doing well, Steve. Thanks for having us on. I appreciate it.
Yeah, so it's interesting how you have the sort of the energy and digital part of things and sort of that, I guess, the bridge between it. And I noticed your hat there. Is that sort of a play on what we're talking about here?
No, it's funny. I get a lot of comments on this hat, and it's like, you're a Texan, but yet you're wearing a, trucker hat that says cowboy hat. And really, it's kind of it's a great segue into really what we're doing with the company, because obviously, AI compute is equates to Silicon Valley, right? And obviously, energy equates to Houston. So obviously, two separate, distinct cultures. And what we're doing is merging the two. Really being that bridge between, AI high compute data centers and of course power generation. So how do we take natural gas, make it into, sustainable, clean energy, and alongside, our AI data centers. So that's really what we're doing.
Yeah, and you're announcing today that phase one engineering is complete for that Texas critical data center. Exciting milestone for the company there, Will.
Absolutely. So again, the Texas critical data centers, that's a joint venture between ourselves and Sharon AI. And of course, that's gone extremely well. So we've acquired 235 acres. We have an option on an additional 203 acres that we're wrapping up our due diligence on. But obviously that's kind of in a prime location in the Permian Basin in Ector County. So Permian Basin, you think about it, heart of the energy for the beating heart for America on all things energy. And obviously, when you look at natural gas, which we just have a glut of in the Permian, people need to start thinking of natural gas in kilowatts, megawatts, not gas, because that's what's going to be driving data centers.
Yeah. And so the news today is basically that all the environment reviews that you had to do, all of which passed, and that's kind of the key here is now you're ready to take sort of the next l big leap, I guess, to getting this into a place where things are actually happening on site.
Oh, absolutely. So obviously there's a lot of work that goes into this. It's not just simply picking, hey, here's 500 acres that where I think a data center may want to come and do something. You need to have access to, for us specifically, because we generate behind the meter power generation. So redundancy on access to gas transmission lines. You also need access to fiber. So we're adjacent to Interstate 20 there. And then of course you need to have the proper land with so water, all of that, right? So all of these nuances, come into play heavily on why a hyperscaler would want to plant their flag here.
Yeah. Next step is a large load interconnection application. So explain that one to us, Will.
Wow. I mean, that
That's the
would be
big stuff, right?
maybe the longest form ever filed with the SEC. I don't know what it costs to edgarize that thing, but it's really interesting. So obviously we're working with a third party firm. So I think what's really of note to investors, to just people that are just interested, right, in what's going on with all these AI data centers, not just in Texas, but nationwide, because it is going to be a drain on our grid. That's a fact. And so for instance, when you look at Texas specifically, look at ERCOT. ERCOT is our grid. It's around 87 megs right now is kind of the current demand. There's 200 megawatts in the queue to be connected. So think about that. Where is that power going to come from? So, I mean, so for us, we really need to understand, most hyperscalers, they want, you have to have reliability first and foremost. Bitcoin mining, you can be intermittent, you can shut them off, shut them down. With AI, high compute, edge compute, you can't do it. They're losing money every minute, significant dollars. So that's why they're so concerned, rightfully so, about the redundancy systems set up to make sure that shutdowns don't occur. And so when you start talking about behind the meter power generation, they also want to be able to have, grid connectivity as well. So that's where that large load study comes in. It's up to a gigawatt of power. So, and just for a frame of reference, just think of like 800 megs powers Denver. I mean, we're talking massive amounts of electricity.
Yeah, and lastly, Will, just on I know when you and I first started talking about this, you know, said, here's what we're trying to do. It seems like you sort of can feel the momentum building now as you get set to sort of take that big critical leap into this critical center.
It's amazing how the positive response that we receive from hyperscalers, you know, a lot of it really is just trying to get comfortable with the behind the meter power generation, to be frank, because no one's really done that. Obviously, you know, Musk has done that in his site out east with, you know, a lot of what they call recip engines of that nature. Because again, most of the sites that do have grid connectivity, they're spoken for. So whether you're talking about, you know, solar, wind, nat gas, I think nuclear, to be real frank, in the next 3 to 5 years, SMR technology is going to be probably surpassing all of us. I think that's what's going to be really interesting. So you start looking at, again, what are cheap, sustainable power sources, right? So, but for right now, natural gas is that bridge.
Absolutely. Well, thanks so much for the update. Really appreciate it. Congratulations on completing phase one, and we look forward to our next conversation, okay?
Let's do it, Steve. Have a great day, okay? Thank you, sir.
Yeah, you as well. There's
All
Will
right.
Gray, the CEO of New Era Energy and Digital.